topic of human reproduction, that is gametogenesis. Now children, what is gametogenesis? Let us now know that. The term gametogenesis is made up of two words, the two terms, that is gameto and genesis. Children, gameto means gametes. The word gameto has been derived from gametes, which means sex cells. Sperms or ovum are the sex cells. Now, the another term is genesis, which means to make or to generate. So, we can define gametogenesis as the process of production of gametes for sexual reproduction. So, gametogenesis, formation of gametes process for sexual reproduction is called gametogenesis. And it is a specific feature among the living organisms, because until the process of formation of gametes will not take place, the fertilization or the next generation will not be coming. So that is why your gametogenesis is one of the specific feature of the sexual reproduction process. Now children, process takes place in germ cells present in primary sex organs, that is testis in males and ovary in females. Now you all know this, these are the basic things which we have discussed before also, that your all the gamete cells, your sex cells are developed from the germ cells. And where are these germ cells located? These germ cells are located inside the primary sex organ. And what are the primary sex organs present in the males and females? In males, testis is the primary sex organ, and in females, ovary is the primary sex organ. So within these organs, germ cells are present, and these germ cells are responsible for the synthesis of gametes, which is also called as sex cells, which are also known as sperms and ovum. Now children, the point which I am going to discuss now, it is very important to understand gametogenesis. Now what is it? Gametes differ from all the cells of body, which is also called as somatic cells, as their nucleus contains only half number, the number of chromosome found in nucleus of somatic cells. Now children, what does this sentence mean? It is little confusing, but it's very, very easy to understand if you follow what I am saying. Now children, every living organism is made up of two types of cell. The one type of cell is called as somatic cell, and the other type of cell is called as generative cell. The two types of cells are somatic cells and the another type is generative cell. Every living organism is made up of these type of cells. Children, now somatic cell is responsible for the formation of body cells. Our body structure, hand, finger, nose, eyes, lungs, organ and everything, they are all body parts, body organs. They are called as somatic cells. So somatic cells are responsible for the formation of body parts and body organs. Generative cells. Now these generative cells are responsible for the formation of gametes. And what are gametes? Gametes are sex cells. So gametes, there are two types of gametes. One is sperm and the other one is ovum. So children, you can see that I have mentioned here somatic cells and generative cells. So hope this is clear, that every living organism is made up of two types of cells, that is somatic cell and generative cell. Somatic cell is responsible to make body cell parts, and generative cell is responsible to make the sex cells, reproductive cells, or we also call it gamete cells, like sperms and ovum. Now the somatic cell, if suppose I am making a somatic cell and it is having a nucleus in it. Inside the nucleus, chromosomes will be present. And this chromosome will be 2n in number, will be diploid in number. And what is, this is body cell. So what is the chromosome number in human beings? It is 46. So the somatic cells having nucleus, having chromosome diploid number, that is 46. When this cell will divide by mitosis division, it will be having 2n and this will also having 2n. It is an equational division. The number of chromosomes in the daughter somatic cell will be maintained. So it is your same equational. So number of chromosomes, that is your diploid number, 46 number of chromosomes will be present in the somatic cells also, and it will be present in the daughter somatic cells also. So this is what your somatic cells means. That means all the cells present inside the body of living organisms, making different body parts and body organs, will be having the diploid number of chromosome, that is your 46 number of chromosome. Children, I am talking about human beings. Human reproduction we are talking, so I am discussing about human beings. And in every living organism, the number of chromosome differs. But in case of human beings, we are having the number of chromosome 46, which is diploid. So somatic cells forming body parts or body organs have a diploid number of chromosome, that is 46. But children, when I talk about generative cell, this generative cell is forming gametes, sperms and ovum. Now sperm is haploid in number and ovum is also haploid in number. What is haploid means? Now this sperm cell and this ovum cell is having its nucleus in it, and this nucleus is having the number of chromosome half. That means it is 23. It is the half number. Why? Because meiosis cell division occurs within the generative cells. Always remember, in somatic cells, in the body part cells, while forming, mitosis cell division occurs. And in generative cells, meiosis cell division occurs. And during meiosis, the number of chromosomes becomes half. That means it is reductional division. And when the gametes like sperms and ovum is formed, the sperm is having a nucleus in it having 23 number of chromosome, and the ovum is having chromosome 23 number. So this was all about your somatic cells and generative cell. Hope children, you have understood that what is your somatic and generative, and we are going to discuss about this part, that how generative cells are being formed, how the number of chromosomes will be maintained throughout the process, that we will be discussing. So this was an important and peculiar feature of gametes, and which we are going to discuss in the later parts of the spermatogenesis and oogenesis while studying the topic gametogenesis. Now children, gametogenesis is controlled by gonadotropin hormone of hypothalamus followed by anterior pituitary. Now we have discussed this before also, that hypothalamus is responsible for the secretion of GnRH hormone, gonadotropin hormone, and this hormone orders the anterior pituitary lobe of pituitary gland to secrete different hormones like LH, FSH, which controls the testes and ovary, and which in return helps in the process of formation of gametes like sperms and ovum. So children, your gametogenesis process is controlled by the hormonal action. Now gametogenesis is responsible for formation of sperms and ova, and the process by which sperms are produced are called spermatogenesis. Spermato, the term spermato has been derived from the word sperms, and genesis means to generate, to make, production. So the process by which your sperms are produced are called as spermatogenesis. And the process by which ova is produced is called oogenesis. So oogenesis, oo word has been derived from ova, and genesis means to produce. So children, the process which is involved in the production of ova is called as oogenesis. These are the two processes which we are going to study in detail in the topic gametogenesis. Now children, your gametogenesis is completed in three phases. Now these three phases are phase of multiplication, phase of growth, and phase of maturation. Now the whole gametogenesis, among sperm's formation and ovum formation, children will be following these three phases. In the first phase, phase of multiplication, the type of cell division, mitosis, takes place. Now after mitosis, the phase of growth occurs when the divided cells grows, they differentiates. Then the last phase of maturation starts, that after attaining full growth, the cells will become mature. And the maturation is completed by the type of cell division called as meiosis. So children, these three phases will be followed and we will be discussing in detail while discussing the formation of sperms in the topic spermatogenesis and the formation of ovum in oogenesis. So now let us move to the spermatogenesis, that how the sperms are being developed inside the main reproductive system. Now let us children discuss the topic spermatogenesis. So I told you all that spermatogenesis is made up of two terms, sperma and genesis. Sperma means sperms and genesis means production. So the formation of sperm is called spermatogenesis. Now children, you all know that where this spermatogenesis occurs, the process takes place in testis, and testis is a primary sex organ of the male reproductive system. That means testis is present in males and spermatogenesis occurs inside the males, among the males. Now testis contains seminiferous tubules and its wall is made up of germinal epithelial cells. Children, it is a revision part. In the male reproduction we have studied all these things. Here, before moving to the spermatogenesis, that how process occurs, let us in brief understand first theory, then diagram, that how the structure is made up. So testis, if you remember, it contains seminiferous tubules, and the seminiferous tubules walls are made up of germinal epithelial cells. If you recall children, that this was, suppose that this was your testis, and inside testis this was your seminiferous tubule, and in this walls, in this wall your germinal epithelial lining was present. Germinal epithelial lining was present. Now if I take here, now I hope you have understood that what it is means, that testis contains seminiferous tubules and your, it is made up of germinal epithelial cells. Now children, germinal epithelial cells contains a special primordial germ cells and it is responsible for spermatogenesis. Now if I draw a diagram of a tubule in this way, suppose this was the germinal epithelium lining of the seminiferous tubule, and within this your, here your primordial germ cells was present, and these primordial germ cells are the spermatogonium cells which are responsible to start children spermatogenesis. So if you don't, if you remember this diagram, this circular diagram, here your primordial germ cells, spermatogonium cells were there, then in between your Sertoli cells were there, then again spermatogonium cells. So such type of structure was there inside the seminiferous tubule where your sperm's production was taking place. So now children, Sertoli cells are present in between primordial germ cells. Sertoli cells provides nutrition to embedded developing sperms in cytoplasm of Sertoli cells. And after the sperms getting matured, they get released in the lumen of seminiferous tubule. Now children, let us understand this diagrammatically again. That suppose that this is your seminiferous tubule and this is the tube of the seminiferous tubule. Now this seminiferous tubule is lined up by a primordial cell, gel primordial cells, and in between your sertilized cells are embedded. These primordial germ cells are the spermatogonium cells. They will be differentiating into spermatogonium cells, and these are in between sertilized cells. Here is the lumen of the seminiferous tubule. This whole seminiferous tubule is opening here into the lumen, and this wall is the wall of seminiferous tubule. Within this wall, the formation of sperms will take place with the help of this primary spermatogonium cells, which will be differentiating into spermatogonium cells, and spermatogonium cells undergoing the three phases, multiplication phase, growth phase and maturation phase, will be developing into sperms, and it will be released into this lumen of seminiferous tubule. Children, this is what the whole theory tells us about the spermatogenesis. Now let us move to the diagram of NCERT, that what actually the spermatogenesis process is. Now children, you can see that I have drawn this whole line diagram on the board, which is depicting the process spermatogenesis. And to the board point of view, and according to the NEET competitive point of view, this whole line diagram is very important. It is important to understand that how the process is being taking place, and how these three phases, multiplication phase, growth phase and maturation phase, is going on, moving on step by step to develop spermatogonium cell into a mature spermatozoa sperms. So children, you can see that I have written on the board three phases: multiplication phase, growth phase and maturation phase. Now on the second side, you can see that I have written here spermatogonium cell, then primary spermatocyte, secondary spermatocyte, spermatid and spermatozoa. This is the sequence that how the sperms will be formed. This was the sequence wise phases that how the spermatogenesis is taking place. The first phase, multiplication phase, followed by second phase, growth phase, and the third phase, maturation phase. I have told you before also children, that sequence wise, when you learn step wise everything, when you learn the names of the phases, when you learn the parts of the names, names of the parts of the organs and the process headings, your step wise, then the learning biology becomes very easy. And with diagram is a supportive to the study of biology. So children, this was the three phases. Now sequence wise development of sperms, the first, it will start with spermatogonium cell. Spermatogonium cell will develop into primary spermatocyte. Primary spermatocyte will be developing into secondary spermatocyte. Secondary spermatocyte will develop into spermatids, and spermatids will develop into spermatozoa, which is also called as sperms. Now children, these are the developmental stages which are taking place inside the seminiferous tubules of testis in males. In the here, the spermatogonium cells are developing from the primordial germ cells. Now children, you can see I have written the differentiation phases. In between spermatogonium and primary spermatocyte, I have written mitosis cell division takes place, differentiation takes place. In between primary spermatocyte and secondary spermatocyte, meiosis occurs, and the first meiotic division occurs in between them. Now secondary spermatocyte developing into spermatids, here your second meiotic division occurs. and spermatids develops into spermatozoa, where body differentiation, development, maturation will take place. Hope children, these three phases, all these things are clear to you all. Again, I'll repeat, the first three phases of the spermatogenesis process is multiplication phase, growth phase, and maturation phase. Then, stepwise, the development of sperms. First, it is spermatogonium cell, then your primary spermatocyte, secondary spermatocyte, spermatids, and your spermatozoa, which is also called sperms. Now, children, in between spermatogonium and primary spermatocyte, the development occurs, differentiation occurs, and the type of cell division is mitosis, which is a equational division. It means that the number of chromosomes present inside the cells will be similar as the parent cell. Now, spermatocyte, in between spermatocyte and secondary spermatocyte, meiotic division occurs, first meiotic division. Then from secondary to spermatid, your second meiotic division occurs, where the number of chromosomes becomes half. Children, in between primary spermatocyte and secondary spermatocyte, the diploid structure spermatogonium undergoes meiosis, first meiotic division, due to which the number of chromosomes here becomes half. It means haploid number of chromosomes. Suppose here your spermatogonium cell is having 46 number of chromosomes. Now this spermatogonium cells, when differentiating into primary spermatocyte, it will be having n number of chromosomes. Now primary spermatocyte, when developing into secondary spermatocyte, will be differentiating now. It will be getting mature now. And then spermatocytes will be developing into spermatozoa, where your differentiation, where your maturation development will be taking place. So this one is your growth phase, this one is your maturation phase, and this one is your multiplication phase. Now children, let us move to the diagram, and this diagram is very, very important to understand according to both point of view as well as for the competitive point of view. Now children, this whole process begins with the onset of puberty. In the males, the male reproductive system gets active after puberty, and the age of puberty is about 13 to 14 years in boys. Now, with the onset of puberty, the spermatogonium cells located in the seminiferous tubule, in the germinal epithelial lining of the seminiferous tubule, it starts developing, and the primordial germ cells differentiates into spermatogonium cell. So children, here I have drawn this ball-like structure, this cell-like structure, and this is your spermatogonium cell. Now this spermatogonium cell is having 2n number of chromosomes. Now children, this spermatogonium cell is having a diploid number of chromosomes, 2n number of chromosomes. Now this spermatogonium cell will divide by mitosis cell division, and it will divide into two cells, again having your 2n number of chromosomes each. This is a division, this is a phase of multiplication, where the number of spermatogonium cells are increasing, 1 into 2, 2 into 4, where the number of spermatogonium cells are increasing. And I told you that millions and millions of sperms are produced. So until and unless this spermatogonium cells undergoes mitotic division, the large number of spermatids will not be produced, spermatozoa will not be produced. So in the beginning, this spermatogonium cell has to undergo, it is very much important for them to undergo mitosis, to develop, to increase, to multiply in numbers. So the number of spermatogonium cells will be increasing. So here, with the same number of chromosome, equational number of chromosome. So 2n number of chromosome in the spermatogonium cell will produce two cells having the diploid number of chromosome. Now this diploid number of chromosome, this cell will divide into two, and this cell will divide into two, again having a diploid number of chromosome. So hope children, you are understanding that how the multiplication phase is going on. So number of cells, number of spermatogonium cells inside the seminiferous tubule, within the wall of seminiferous tubule, are getting increased. Their number is increasing. So many numbers of spermatoconium cells are formed. Now once children, when large number of spermatoconium cells are formed, now those spermatoconium cells will move ahead to the next phase, which is called as growth phase. Multiple number of cells have been formed. Now they will be growing. They will be growing by the meiosis division will be taking place. And this now you can see I haven't drawn here. I have taken only one cell. So this one of the diploid spermatoconium cell will divide into two cells by your first meiotic division, and the number of chromosome will become half. It is a reductional division. This one is reductional division. And children, here it was equational division, where number of chromosomes were same in each daughter cells. But what happens in the growth phase, where these spermatoconium cells now undergoes meiotic division, first meiotic division, and the number of chromosomes present in the nucleus of the parent spermatoconium cell now divides into half-half. That means if here it was 46 number of chromosome, here the number will reduce, and here in this cell it will become 23, and here it will become 23. So that means this diploid is having 46 number of chromosomes. So now here this will have 23 and this will have 23. Now children, after the first meiotic division, when two reductional division goes and two daughter cells are formed from the spermatoconium cell, two primary spermatocytes are formed. Now slowly, slowly it will be moving to the second meiotic division, and growth phase will be maturing. Growth phase will be developing. You can see that this phase, first meiotic division, developing from primary spermatocyte to secondary spermatocyte, is the growth phase. So here the two cells which are formed, these two cells will be dividing, and these cells will be developing, these cells will be growing. Now these two cells here, now again I have left children this cell, I have taken the example of only one cell. Now this cell will again grow having haploid number of chromosomes. So here also 23 number of chromosomes, and the cells are growing. So this is moving to the growth phase. So this one yours, this one is your growth phase. So primary spermatocyte changing into secondary spermatocyte by the second meiotic division will be having a growth phase. Now this secondary spermatocyte will be going to the second meiotic division. So here it was growing. Now here again the your differentiation will be, your growth phase will be taking place. This is also your maturation phase. From this stage to this stage, your from the development of secondary spermatocyte till the development of spermatozoa will be your maturation phase. So from starting from here till here, this one is your maturation phase. But within this cells also, this cell is again going to divide into two. This is again going to divide into two, having n number of chromosomes, haploid number of chromosomes. But they are now going, they are now growing, they are now moving because of the developmental stages, that is called as maturation phase. Now the cells which have grown here, now the secondary spermatocyte which have grown, now that secondary spermatocyte will differentiate, will develop, it will become mature. So secondary spermatocyte divides into two, this secondary spermatocyte divides into two, and four spermatids are produced from one. Similarly, this will be also following the same process, and four spermatids will be produced. So suppose, so think children, that from one cells, so how so many numbers of spermatids are going to be produced. So these spermatids now, they undergo during maturation phase, and they develop into spermatozoa, sperms. And these spermatozoa, these sperms, now after getting matured, they get released into the lumen of seminiferous tubule, from where the sperms are being released out from the body of the males and it is transferred to the body of the female reproductive system. Hope children, this whole process diagrammatically it was clear to you all. I'll repeat the phases, three phases: first multiplication phase, second growth phase, third maturation phase. Then division, first mitosis division occurs, then meiosis first and second occurs, and then your differentiation occurs. Then according to the parts, your spermatogonium develops into primary spermatocyte, then secondary spermatocyte, then spermatids and spermatozoa. And this was the whole explanation that how your sperms are being produced, spermatozoa is being produced from the spermatogonium cells. Let us children now discuss few important terms related to spermatogenesis process. The four terms which we are going to discuss here in this topic is spermiation, semination, ejaculation and insemination. These are the four important terms which we are going to discuss, and we have discussed before also, you are already knowing it, but though it is in the topic, so we have to discuss it. So what is spermiation? You know that release of sperms from Sertoli's cell. Where is Sertoli's cell located? Within the seminiferous tubule. So within the seminiferous tubule, inside the Sertoli's cells, your spermatozoa gets developed and they take nutrition from it, and after developing it gets released from the Sertoli's cells. So that release process of spermatozoa from the Sertoli's cells is called spermiation. We have discussed this term before also. Now second is semination, release of sperm from testis. Now after spermiation is a release of sperms from Sertoli's cells. Now children, from Sertoli's cells, where does the sperms move? It moves into the lumen of the seminiferous tubule. Now passing through the lumen of seminiferous tubule, it will be moving out. So when it moves out from the testis, where is seminiferous tubule located? It is located inside the testis. So after the spermiation process, when the sperm enters inside the lumen of seminiferous tubule, now the seminiferous tubule carries that sperms out from the testis, and that process is called semination. So after spermiation, semination occurs. Spermiation is a process of release of sperms from Sertoli's cells, and semination is a process of release of sperms from the testis of the male reproductive system. Then the third one is ejaculation. Release of sperms from the body of male is called ejaculation. When the sperms is ejaculated out from the male reproductive system. Now the sperm is not present either inside the seminiferous tubule, neither it is present in the testis, and now it is also not present in the male reproductive system. It is out from the male body. So when it is released out, when the sperms are released out from the male reproductive system, then it is called ejaculation. But what will happen after ejaculation? The sperms will be inserted, the sperms will be transferred into the vagina of the female reproductive system, and transfer process is called as insemination. Hope children, all the four terms and the difference between them is clear to you all. I have described all of them sequence wise according to the development till the liberation. So spermiation, semination, ejaculation and insemination are all the release process of the sperms from the seminiferous tubule, from the Sertoli's cells and from the male reproductive system till the transfer into the female reproductive tract. Hope children, this whole topic related to spermatogenesis is clear to you all. Thank you.